Hello, my name is Aashima and this is my book den. So this is my younger sister. Okay, introduce yourself.
Yo, my name is Afulka.
Okay, this is like the worst introduction of the century, but we'll take it. Okay, so today we are going to be doing a quiz which is titled in BuzzFeed as the hardest game of would you rather for book nerds. And we are doing this because content. So yeah. So this is gonna be fun because she reads a lot of mythology. Have you read any other genre, like apart from mythology? You've read one book on World War II, that I remember. Like, if Adolf Hitler was alive after... Have you read that? No, you haven't.
The Summer of the Bartians. About Russian Revolution.
Yeah, so along the lines of war and tragedy. Okay, so apart from mythology, she has read about the Russian Revolution in fiction, okay? And yeah, basically that's it. But she's read a lot of mythology. Devdutt Patnaik, favorite mythology author? Please, don't be... Okay, so this is an inside joke, so you won't get it, but don't be Aditya. So, we're gonna start the quiz and let's see what are the answers. So, every time I answer, we'll get like a poll like, how many percentage of people answered this and how many opted for the second option. So the first question is, would you rather have a friend who loses your books or one who dog ears them?
One who loses.
Are you insane?
I can buy one more.
You can buy one more? This is so opposite to myself. I am such a penny pincher. I'm like, don't lose my book, like dog ear it, write all over it, like okay, so dog ear it, write all over it, but you can't lose it. It's like all money down the toilet. Okay, so actually I'm in the 80%, like 80% people opted for dog ear and 20% book losers. So
loser,
no, those who opted, like he can lose the book, he can't dog ear the book. So the second question is, would you rather secretly love a book everyone else hates or secretly hate a book everyone else loves?
Secondly.
Okay, so you would like to hate a loved book. Huh? Secretly hate a book. Or secretly love a book. Huh, that's the convenient option. Secretly hate a loved book. Because we are humans, we need validation. I think what you think about me is important. So yeah. So, we both come in the 42%, like, I'm just being sarcastic, I don't care. So, it just makes it more easy. It just makes it more easy. Like, if you hide it, and you don't have to debate it with someone, right? Like, okay, I'm okay with you, like, loving that book. Like, people love Chetan Bhagat books around me. I don't shame them. I think they do go on to read better books, so yeah, that's one advantage, but we won't get into that drama right now. That's another whole video. So, okay. So the third question is, would you rather be stuck on a very long plane or train ride without a book? So a plane or a train ride?
Plane.
Plane ride. So plane, while sitting in planes, have you like felt like this is, I'm most disturbed in plane and car. Like, I have travel sickness. I can't bear planes and cars. And she knows.
Like, and I can't bear her.
So, I vomit, like not right now. Like, on planes, I think I can. But in cars, while traveling through those pin roads and hill stations like Mount Abu and Munnar, I can vomit, like, at every bend. Seriously, I'm that sick while traveling. So, in trains, I can read peacefully. And in... So, that's why. I'm a... distracted reader also, so I can't read in like public places with crowd around me. Like, can you read in public places like headphones? You've never done that, huh? You've never actually tried. I have tried. I haven't been able to read like in public places with people around. And like, I don't know, I get conscious plus I'm distracted. Like, I don't mind my own fucking business in a public place. I'm like, what is everyone doing there?
Bus.
Yeah, in buses.
Every day.
Because you know those people, right? Like, you go on and off. Every day you go with them, right?
But I didn't know any of them.
That's... Like, you're seeing them. Like, you see their faces every day. That's it. Okay, so the fourth question is, would you rather have dinner with your favorite author or your favorite character? Favorite author, favorite character. Characters are hot. Like, authors are amazing. Authors can be anything.
My favorite author is Mary.
You read mythology? Like, oh god, this is scandalous. Yes. Please avoid this. Choose one from Summer of Bashan's Keys. Like, but all of them are assholes. Okay, so Summer of Bashan's Keys, as far as I remember, I don't think anyone was dateable enough. One was like pining too hard for a girl who didn't want to be with him, and the other one was like oblivious. Oh, this girl loves me, I'll not look at her for the entire book, and just in the last, I'll do an arranged marriage. So, but I have read a lot of books where there are so like hot male characters, so I will go with fave character. Yes. So, fave character 83%, fave author 17%.
There are no hot authors, I think.
We didn't check for the train one. Oh, train and plane one, it's 50 and 50%. Like, wow. Okay. So, the next is, would you rather date a character you have a crush on or your crush from real life?
My real life crushes are a-holes.
And you don't have like fictional crushes. So what would you do? Okay, this is a bizarre situation we have right now. Any of the book, you must have read. Didn't you read any YA book? There are so many hot guys in YA book. Like, one of them, even though the girl or the boy is nerdy and the other one is like this hot basketball player, the other nerdy one like comes one day where they look hot. So I don't have any regrets. I have a lot of choices.
I have mostly read mythology, history, currently reading poetry.
So you don't have like fictional or real life, are just too mundane. Okay, the real life ones I know, so okay. So for me, it's character crushes, because real life crushes are dumb. Okay, I'm sounding like, okay, what was the name of the protagonist in Mean Girls? I am forgetting Mean Girls. I need to rewatch it. Okay. It's a classic. Okay. It's a classic. Okay. I'm forgetting it. Okay. So character crush, 63% voted for it, and in real life crush, 37%. Tells a lot. Then, would you rather have your favorite book turned into a movie or your favorite movie turned into a book? That's a serious... Like, this is not seriously a question even. Like,
I think movie turned into a book.
What?
Because they will spoil the book which we like if the movie is not good enough.
But movies turning into books is horrendous. Like, actually imagine Bollywood movies, like 90s movies, being turned into a book. It will be like a leaflet.
चाहिए कैसी रहेगी?
इस किताब में कितने पेजेस हैं?
सिर्फ 800.
पतली किताब लेकर आओ.
अच्छा ये.
हाँ ये ठीक है.
Okay, movie based on book. Movie based on a book, because books are better. They have stories. They try to pass the Bechdel test. Most often they do not, but there are a lot of good books. But books,
even Chetan Bhagat books look good when turned into a movie.
The movies are better.
That's the beauty.
Oh yeah. So but there are movies that have failed the books, like that are like worse. Because The Fault in Our Stars, okay. I do mention The Fault in Our Stars a lot, but these are retellings. These are not like the books rigidly. The books. That's why they played around it. So the seventh question is, would you rather read a book with an annoying cliffhanger or one where your favorite character is killed off?
The one where my favorite character is killed off.
Are you nuts?
You will grow more feeling towards the character if he she dies.
I think Kevin Mitchell said this in an interview with Helly. So Kevin Mitchell said this, like, you need to make people empathize with the characters, so you need to make their life so tough that people cry for them. So this is like one of the ways, like either you kill one off or either you just give them a hard life, that's it. But I would rather love a cliffhanger. But cliffhangers are in series, right? Like in standalones there are just open endings and I'm used to them, so I won't mind them. And cliffhanger is the obvious choice. 61% people. Your option, killing off my favorite character, 39% only. It's not only, it's a lot of people actually that have lost their minds. So, eighth question is, would you rather lose the ability to read any new book or the ability to reread books you have already read? So, which one would you choose? No new books or no rereading? No rereading, right? Yeah, I think I'll agree with you in this one. 79%. For one moment I thought it's no new books, and I'm like, what? People are mad. 79% of the people. So, yeah, so no rereading. 79% people agree with us. Yeah, we are same. Would you rather live in a library or a bookstore? It's almost the same, right? You're just surrounded by books. Like, if I live in a bookstore, I don't really need to buy those books, right, to read them.
Sure.
But I think they give employee discounts and things like that. So, but still, library. Free. I told you, I am all for, like, money saving. I'm not chindi,
chindi
so,
is the word.
We are in like the unpopular option, but it's not that low. So 43% people want to live in a library and 57% in a bookstore. I think they don't know the idea, like if they want to live in a bookstore, maybe they'll not be allowed to read, maybe they'll have to purchase, but they'll get a coupon or something, maybe. I'm just imagining things here, okay? This is not a real life scenario. This will never happen. So I'm just guessing. Then, would you rather lose your place or get a paper cut every time you read a book? Lose a place is like you're reading a page and you just forget like where you were.
First.
Of course. It's torturous. Paper cuts are torturous. Like knee scrapes are nothing in front of it. Paper cuts are the most underrated devils, I tell you. So, always losing place, 73%, yeah. And, oh god. There are 27% people who would like paper cuts than losing place. Who are these people? So, so the next is, this is another level of BDSM, like with books. So then next is, would you rather have to always read in the dark or always read books with tiny text? This is getting annoying with every question. Like, in the dark or reading tiny text?
In the dark.
What? Okay, it depends. Like, tiny text, how much tiny? Like, the tininess is subjective, if it's a word. So, have you read, like, you do have, like, Collins Classics, right? What was the name of the book? Solomon Northup's 12 Years a Slave, I think that's the name of the book. And it has been turned into a movie. I haven't read the book. I haven't seen a movie. So, okay, so you tell me, like, was the text irritating? Because I find it so much irritating when the text is that tiny. Collins Classics are the worst. Don't ever buy them. It's a waste of money. So, I have read, like, tiny text, Animal Farm, the Penguin edition, it has a tiny text, so I think I'll be okay with it, but if it's, like, Collins Classics tiny, I am going to burn the book, even without buying it. So, yeah. So, I'll be okay with reading tiny text, because that is another case. Just, what about you?
Let's say first option.
Reading the dark, yeah. The forward. So you will like to read in the dark than tiny text.
I have read in the dark.
When? Okay, so are they saying like there's a torchlight? Like, of course, you can't read in the dark. Like, literally in the dark.
There was just light coming in the room from outside. I just went to the window.
When? And what book? What book was it that you had gone to such an extent to read that book?
It was Mahabharata.
The Devdutt Patnaik. Jaya.
Yeah,
so Jaya has a larger text, so maybe it's easy to read in the dark. Maybe. I don't know. haven't experimented. This, I have written in the dark. I have not read in the dark.
I have written in the dark. I have searched for things in the dark.
What things? Would you rather read by a fireplace or on the beach? My answer is in front of the fireplace, because
if it's winter, fireplace.
But it's Kerala, so fireplace is not even an option. It's like no winters, tropical, near the equator. No, we can't. Yeah, so we can't have fireplace. But I will say fireplace, like
classic.
No, it's not classic. So the thing is, I'm a distracted reader, as I've said. So when you go to the beach, there are like people playing in the water. Your own family is playing in the water. You sit with a book on the beach, they'll think you're mad. And I get distracted. I can't read on a beach. Simply because all of the people are having fun. Like, reading is fun, okay? Reading is fun, but not equivalent to playing in the water. Or like seeing other people having fun. That's it. Okay. So,
I would go like reading the book and then throwing it somewhere.
Actually, fireplace is a popular option, 69%. Beach, 31%, because all of us want to play on beach, not read on the beach.
And second thing, classy. Oh my god.
No, it's not classy, it's like fireplace. Classy. No. When you sit in front of the fireplace, like, not even fireplace, like, because the question mentioned it, I said fireplace, because like, apart from beach, if you say a hotel room, okay. Like, you can sit there. But, like, in a car, I can't read. Because there is a lot going on both the sides. So, I need to see the drama. Okay. So, that's it. In a cafe, I can't read. I want to see the other people. I can't mind my fucking business. I said it.
How would you read in a bookstore?
Bookstore is like, everyone is minding their own business. They're holding their worlds in their hand. Yeah. It's only the bookstore people that are roaming around. So they are not even interesting, like, until they walk up to me and like...
Interesting?
Yeah, they are not
interested.
Doing...
Interested?
I am saying they are not interesting to look at. Like, I am not distracted by them. They are just roaming around. Like, if they are coming up to me and giving me some recommendations, I think, okay, I'll look up from the book, I'll talk to them, and maybe I'll put aside the book. That is a way of distraction in bookstores. But I think I have read in a bookstore, Crossword Bookstore, I have read Jaipur one, like, not here. Here, there wasn't even a seat. Yeah, another petition, please have seats in bookstores. Please! You want to sign the petition? Like, verbally? Yes, okay. We get the answer. She signed the petition. You can also in the comment section. I'm just kidding, please, okay? So,
everybody would be like, change.org.
So, okay, so I'll be leaving the link down to this quiz below in the description box. So you can also like play with us, let me know some of the answers. Are our answers quirky? Did you relate to us or were we different? And do you want to say anything? Like, do you want to promote something? Your social media. Okay, so if you enjoyed the video, like the video, comment down with your answers to these questions, and also try to do the quiz, and share my videos, and subscribe for more bookish content. Please press the bell icon, like, subscribe, please. Okay, look into the camera, subscribe, please. Oh god, okay, she's not ready to say it. Subscribe to my channel for more bookish content, press the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video, and also for my community goals. Bye! 아무래도 어색해서 못해 우리들 사이엔 우리 둘만 모르게 그어진 성